is the channel. Welcome to today's show. I apologize if my voice sounds a little different today. I'm suffering from either severe allergies, the flu, or maybe some of that chemtrail pixie dust has gotten into my system. But nonetheless, I will continue to provide content the best that I can. If you haven't heard, there's been a lot of glitches going on in the national radar systems, the weather radar systems going on, not just around North America, but around the Earth. We obviously saw the anomaly out to sea that scientists thankfully told us were just rogue waves. Well, we're seeing the weather system continue to go down, and then people are getting drilled with strange weather phenomenons. So in other words, people were told it was going to be a sunny day. They went to check their hourly, and the weather was down. And of course, they were hit with hail, tornadoes, and other weather that wasn't forecasted ahead of time. And this is something we're probably going to see on a repeated basis so that they can sneak attack people with weather anomalies. That's right. For people out there that aren't paying attention, the climate agenda is so that the government can get away with wiping you out with weaponized weather. It is not a conspiracy. It is a fact. They've been talking about the race for weather control, the control of the weather modification systems, and they have it. And now we can obviously see the behavior of the government is a completely rogue government hell-bent on dividing the citizens. And now they are using their pre-planned weather manipulation to hit you with weather. And of course, they've ingrained sayings like you can't control Mother Nature, you can't control the weather into your head, so that you're not suspicious at all about it. And what should make people suspicious is how the national radar weather systems are going offline and coming back online, and then suddenly there's just huge, huge bizarre tornado effects. Let me show you the clip from the Today Show on NBC, because they're just acting like this is normal, right? That's what they do. They just pretend like this is normal. Oh well, and if there is any, if you are suspicious at all about it, as to why the things are going offline, coming back online, that we're having multi-day severe risks, 25 million people at risk of hail, up to 2 inches or larger, multiple tornadoes, wind gusts over 60 miles per hour, multiple days just sitting there, right? The storm's not moving out, it's just sitting over specific regions, right? But they don't want you to be suspicious of that, because if you are, we're not paying attention to the, quote, climate change crisis that's going on, which, of course, is nothing more than them doing weather manipulation and weather modification. And then, of course, acting like this is normal to have a multi-day severe risk with 25 million people at risk of a storm that's pretty much just sitting over isolated areas. Look.
Millions of Americans are once again in the path of severe weather, the potential for tornadoes, flooding, rain, high winds. Al's very busy tracking it all morning now.
Hey, good morning, guys, and we are looking already at severe weather firing up. We got tornado watches from Nebraska all the way down to Iowa, and we're looking at even some tornado warnings right now in parts of Kansas, so we're watching this very closely. This is part of a big developing storm that's rapidly intensifying in strength, and as it moves out this morning, we're looking at these strong storms moving into the Midwest, isolated flash flood potential. We're also looking today and tonight, 25 million people at risk for wind gusts of up to 60 miles per hour, damaging hail and tornadoes, especially in this hatched area, EF2 or more, from Cedar Rapids, Des Moines, on into Quincy. This moves tomorrow to the east into the Ohio River Valley, with rain arriving on the East Coast by later tomorrow. In fact, 19 million people at risk from Detroit, Cleveland, Louisville, Indianapolis, Columbus. Heaviest rain is going to be in the upper Ohio and Mississippi River valleys and on up right through the northern plains. Hourly rates 1 to 2 inches per hour.
And of course, on top of that, you have them spinning propaganda about why the weather radar systems are down. Well, really the reason is they don't want you to be able to prepare when you just get hit out of nowhere with a tornado. They don't want you to be able to find a bunker somewhere. They don't want you to run to the store and stock up on supplies, which is another reminder that everybody out there hopefully is stocked up on some supplies, because at any point in time, no matter where we are, we can be hit with one of these things. This isn't just something that's going to happen in places that are used to tornadoes, places that are used to hurricanes. They are going to be hitting people all over the place, and they're not going to be just because they're warmer and it's causing tornadoes in the mountains now. And you're going to go, wait a minute, I thought tornadoes only formed like not in the mountains, in the opposite of the mountains. Well, it's a new type of tornado. It's a hybrid tornado. Oh, right. And now we're seeing, instead of two tornadoes sweeping through the Midwest, we're seeing 45 tornadoes sweeping through the Midwest. Midwest. But don't be suspicious, because the climate is 2 degrees warmer Celsius. So this is all expected. And what we need to do about it is give up our rights, stay indoors, and then they won't hit us with weather manipulation anymore if we all agree to be prisoners for them. So weather radar systems from the National Weather Service experienced a mass outage on Sunday and on Monday, at least the third such incident in a month. Alerts shared on social media suggested that roughly half of all NWS weather radars experienced a major outage in the early hours Monday morning as major storm systems developed across the plains. Well, maybe Big Brother was worried
that, was hot,
that people were going to see complete clear sky days, or maybe, you know, if you're looking at the cloud map, don't be suspicious when you see the entire country under clouds, because, of course, those are chem clouds. But they didn't want anyone to be suspicious as to why suddenly and where suddenly all of these things were picking up and coming out of thin air. So they shut it down for a little while, turned it back on, and made sure that you were unprepared to get wiped out with these clearly weaponized weather events. So, listen to this story out of St. Louis. During the night in question, which was Sunday when this began, a major storm system hit close to St. Louis that was big enough for a tornado to form. Due to the radar outage, warning sirens did not go off, and everyone living within the region was put in grave danger. Local meteorologists apparently tracked the system by just studying lightning strikes alone. Some 17 tornadoes touched down during the outage. And again, this is so that you are caught off guard, completely unprepared. And they have a reason not to warn you, right? They have a reason not to sound the tornado alarms. You know, they have, just like in Maui, right? Oops, oopsies, we forgot to sound the alarms and warn you about that fire coming in. Oops, yep, we're sorry, we forgot to warn you about those tornadoes so that you could seek shelter. Our bad, you know, and don't even worry about 17 tornadoes popping up out of nowhere. That's completely normal. Yeah. Is it?
Holy cow. Well, what are you doing?
So it says,
out of the way.
On April 11th, a radar and communications outage hit NWS Wakefield, Virginia, through to Dover, Delaware, as data could not be disseminated during a period when a severe thunderstorm was expected to hit the area. It is unclear why these systems keep going offline, but every time they do, the risk to human life and infrastructure goes up significantly. Knowing the weather forecast is so vital to human activity that one of the first things the Nazis did when they invaded Amsterdam was to remove it from the newspaper. As of now, the National Weather Service has not responded to any inquiries about the outage. So we can see where this is headed, right? I mean, this is what we're up against. We're up against a rogue government, a psychotic government, who probably is more angry than ever because the real data of how many people poisoned themselves wasn't living up to the expectations they had. However, part of Agenda 2030, the main component of it, is the climate agenda. So this gives them carte blanche to ramp this up, to ramp up. You know, it's more than just HAARP in Alaska. Okay, we know they have CERN. They have many, many of these artificial aurora machines, these high-frequency radio pulses in the ionosphere. They can swirl this thing up. A lot of people believe the actual St. Louis arches are a weather-controlling device. And I'm one of those people who thinks so, too. I'm sure some of you have heard that theory before, of course. Why would we not believe that theory? And then we see all these tornadoes popping up right next to St. Louis, right next to the arches. But it couldn't be, right? It couldn't be. They just made this huge archway, you know, because somebody was just like, hey, you know, why don't we just build a 623-foot stainless steel archway in the middle of St. Louis, right? And then, of course, all the theories out there about what is going to be there.
I'm good. Just here early.
These are all just mere coincidences, of course. So we have to keep an eye on this, because as we move forward, this is how they're going to get all of us. And they're going to be able to use weaponized weather not only to manipulate the weather, but to manipulate a lot of these states that are being conservative states with HAARP, with direct energy weapons, and blame it on forest fires, the coasts, with tsunamis. This is what their plan is. This is what the blueprint has been. And they've continually ingrain the climate crisis into your head so that this is what they can blame it on. Because if there wasn't a built-in boogeyman and people actually paid attention to government patents and all the things that the government has told us they were trying to do, going back to JFK, talking about, oh, well, we want to figure out how to control the weather. Oh, yeah, how come? Well, it could be a big benefit to us in a war. And the time just goes by over and over, years. And you say to yourself, wait a minute, who are we at war with, right? Oh, we're at war with the boogeyman over in these other countries. Oh, wait a minute, it looks like the government's at war with their own citizens. And if you don't comply to what they want, which is to enslave you in a artificial intelligence-governed world, well, guess what? They'll lead you to states they want to lead you to, whether it's a state like Missouri, or to hit you with tornadoes, or Oklahoma, or lead you to Florida and drill you with hurricanes. And nobody will think differently of it. It's the perfect weapon for them to use because it's a silent weapon. It's something that nobody will be able to wrap their head around. And nobody will think that people can be this wicked anyway. That's why it's so hard for people to grasp. Hey, you know, the government has weaponized weather capabilities during Vietnam War, Operation Popeye, the Great Monsoons, etc. People just automatically, their brain just shuts off. Really? They don't want to know about Harvard. They don't want to know about the Arches. They don't want to know about CERN. It's too hard for them to grasp. So we can expect in the future more of these, you know, the radars to go offline. Of course, again, how is the entire national radar going offline? Right? Does anybody know how that's happening? And is anyone concerned? Is anyone concerned when a giant blob appears on a radar out in the middle of the ocean and people get suspicious about it? They go, hey, it's a data error. Oh, it's a data error. Just like during crimes that are committed when the CCTV cameras can be off. Eh, we don't know why they're off. Oh, you don't know why they're off. Oh, okay. You don't have to be held accountable then, right? Oh, you know, we'll talk about the bridge implosions. Oh, right. Well, how did that happen? How did the power on the ship go off? Oh, we don't know. You know, maybe it was Russia. Oh, maybe it was Russia. Right. And then, of course, oh, the weather system is down, and then, boom, tornadoes pop up. No sirens go off. Nobody is alerted of this. And then you look over at Maui and you say, hey, didn't they just have like a huge fire? They didn't alert anybody there. There's a lot of missing kids and other things over there that they haven't, you know, told us about, that they've just dismissed and dropped and won't bring attention to it anymore. Anybody suspicious yet? If you're not, you're not paying attention, or you're just telling yourself that nothing's going on. But everybody can feel it and everybody can see it. Those of us with eyes to see and ears to hear. I thank everybody for being here. I hope you're all doing well. God bless you as always and your families.